Hey peeps, how you doing? How you doing today? You doing good? That's good. Me, I'm doing good. Feel like I've been busy this morning, but I don't think I really have. Oh, well, yeah, I did. I went in the kitchen, straightened my kitchen up, made the dishwater, wiped stuff down. I fixed the hubby some lunch today. He liked bologna sandwiches and stuff like that, so I made him up three. I put ham, bologna, and salami on it with some cheese and everything. So I made him up three of them. And he liked it fried in a skillet. So I did that. But I ain't got no cucumbers and some tomatoes. So I'm thinking probably after I finish washing dishes. I don't know how long Aldi stay open. But probably run to Aldi's right quick and get some tomatoes and cucumbers. Because he liked that on his sandwiches. I don't know. I wasn't even thinking about it when I went out. Because we went to Walmart yesterday. Because the ADT motion, hall motion detector, battery was low. So it required a 3-volt battery. So I had, because it was beeping, beeping, and that's nerve wracking. So yeah, we had went out yesterday to get the battery and came back. I had got the wrong, it was a 3-volt battery, but it wasn't the right size battery. And I'm like, I ain't even know it was that serious. Like, if I would have been thinking, I could have had picked up the cucumbers and tomatoes yesterday. Ugh, that wasn't even on my mat. And I was rushing. Because I forgot the battery itself. But he took it back and got the right battery. So no chirp, chirp, chirps and stuff. So yeah, I'll probably run to Aldi's later on. And today. Y'all want to know what today is? Today is June 12th at 12:15 in the p.m. Wednesday. Hump day. Yes, y'all. Yes. So, what I do yesterday, I washed yesterday. I had two loads. Cleaned up my bathroom. That was like a whole, yeah, that just washing and cleaning up that bathroom wore me out. So yeah, and he had to wash the dishes, and after I finished washing dishes, he had to get ready and put clothes on and go out to Walmart. Yeah, I feel sleepy. So yeah, that's just been my Tuesday and today. Tomorrow we go out. I'll be getting my layaway out tomorrow at Rainbow. And go to Michael's and get the t-shirts. Maybe, I'm trying to see, I need to go down there today and see. Because I have iron-on letters, but I need to see, do I have the letters that I need for these shirts? So I'm going to go do that today. I'm going to do that sometime today too. So I know tomorrow if I need to get some more white, different kind of white letters. I don't know. But the letter's going to be white. And, so yeah, that's what I will be doing. And so today, y'all, only one read. I know, I know, I know. It's a sad day today. Because I ain't doing my other read. But like I said, I'm behind a read, and the way I want to mark my this paper off is so I can finish right up when I'm getting ready to take my YouTube break. Yeah, so I'm trying to stay on schedule. So, because next week is our last week of school. So, yeah. I don't know I'm going to do a read Friday. I'm going to do a read Monday. And I'm going to do a read, I don't know, I think the way I got it broke up, I should be finished next week, Friday. Yeah, that'll be my last week, y'all. So, we ain't going to talk about that till next week. But yeah. So, other than that, it's gloomy outside. It's raining. It's really like, done got real dark. It was kind of bright earlier, but the clouds are moving in front of the sun. So, yeah, but it's supposed to be 72 today, 69 tomorrow. Like, it's June. What did I say it is? June. Did I say June? Did you say the 12th? Yeah, June 12th, and we getting still 69 degrees. I mean, I'm not really complaining. Cause for some reason, 80s be hot. But yeah, it's just kind of like, Yeah, but y'all, I ain't gonna do too much talking because I am kind of tired. I went to bed kind of late last night. I dozed off and then I woke back up. And when I woke back up, it took me a long while to go back to sleep. And I started watching this TV show, this movie that came on TV last night. Well, who was in that movie? It was good. I'm drawing a blank. I'm seriously. What was it? Lorenz Tate was in it. And Tyrese. It was good. And Megan Good. Yeah. So yeah, that was good. I stayed up to that one off. I think I woke up to do a bathroom run, and I couldn't go right back to sleep. So I'm like, well, let me just start watching something on TV. I think it was on Bounce. So yeah, that's why I don't know what time it went off, around 2 something. For real. It just happens. I'm like, really? I'm kind of sort of used to it because this is it. You know, I don't know. Maybe they'll pass, but I've been going through this for a while now. Waking up in the middle of the night, not being able to go back to sleep. Sometimes 2 o'clock, sometimes 3 o'clock. I doze back off. It all depends. Like, I don't know. But I'm good. I still know how to function and get her done throughout my day. I just kind of be a little sluggish sometimes and stuff. But I know how to push through it. Like, you know, I know how to push through stuff like that. That's what I was telling my hubby. I have, like, one of those type of endurance. You know, when you got a lot of kids, especially girls, heads you have to do, bells you have to give, and just up and they get sick, you be up all throughout the night. I think my body just programmed like that, my mind programmed to just endure, push through the tiredness, push through the sluggishness. But I am getting older, so yeah, but I still push through. So yeah, y'all read it. I mean, it's a short read. It's a really short read. So this is going to probably be a short video. We'll see. So let me get into this read. I'm reading from Basic Concepts. What kind of hurts are we talking about? That's one. That's the subject. And now the topic, why bother with past hurts? Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it. Now I'm getting ready to go into another one. How did I read this? Oh, I did read this, y'all. I just didn't mark it. I read this. What was Monday the 10th? I think I marked the wrong thing. That's what happened, y'all. Oh, I see. I'm like, I remember reading this. How do we? No, so this ring is not. Yeah. Okay. How do we know when healing happens? Y'all ready? Let's find out how we know when healing happens. Regular study of the Bible over many years has taught me that God wants us to progress from being totally self-centered, our condition in infancy, to being God and other-centered, from primary concern for what we want or need to concern for what God wants and others need. I got that right. He wants us to progress from being self-centered and thinking about us. That's how we are in infancy, you know, when we babies, you know. Yeah. To progress into being more God-centered and other people-centered. Okay. And becoming true instruments of God's peace in a troubled and selfish world. Wow, I like that. That is true maturity, true holiness. Holiness, God wants holiness. You must be holy the day you go and see the Lord. Hey, I remember singing that in a choir. I don't know the title. That's a That is true maturity, true holiness, real manhood, and real womanhood. Wow. For far too many people, religious rituals and practices focus on itself. How to manipulate a higher power to produce a benefit for the supplicant. True Christianity, on the other hand, expects us to leave self behind while remaining in control of what we do. A remarkable feat that is totally beyond all human ability. That I believe is why God gave us the gift of the Holy Spirit. It's a gift, y'all. When God give you the Holy Spirit, it's a gift. Not people just give you gifts. Holy Spirit is a gift from God. Now, does anyone understand being God and other-centered does not mean neglecting our own needs? On the contrary, it requires meeting our needs so that we can serve God and others without our needs interfering. Wow, I like that. While we can serve God and others without our needs interfering. I mean, you have to practice that. Because back in the day, I used to try to do the God thing, and then somebody will say something, and then I'd get in my feelings, start focusing on my feelings, and like, I'm like, well, I'm gonna put the God thing on the back burner right now because I'm feeling some type of way right now. Because my feelings will get all up in the way. And I'm like, look, I don't think I'm cut out for this. You have to practice that. You have to practice keeping your emotions in check when you're trying to be there. And be there for other people and do the God thing. You know what I'm saying? But you don't, and like you said, you got to be taking care of yourself as well, you know, and that's all about balance, everything, man. Yeah, let me finish reading. Okay. In addition, we must recognize that desires are not needs. To confuse them is a sign that we need greater maturity. Okay, I'm done, but let me reread that part again. In other words, our primary concern should not be ourselves, but we should take care of ourselves. In addition, we must recognize that desires are not needs. To confuse them is a sign that we need greater maturity. Got it done, y'all. And I like that. Desires are not needs. Wow. Because in the Bible it says God will give you, if you seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and all this righteousness, God will give you the desires of your heart. And then it is like, it's not a need, because in the same way he say, don't worry about what you should eat or what you should wear, because if I could feed the birds, how much more that I could feed you and clothe you and all that. So he take care of the need thing. But that desire thing, if you seek the, you know, the kingdom of heaven and all this righteousness, I will give you the desires of your heart. That's just not going to be given like that. Like making ways for you to have a roof over your head. That's a need. Food, a need. Clothes on your back, a need. He makes provisions for those things. Whether you worship him or not. But them desires of your heart things, oh, that's a whole nother level. You have to be like worshiping him in his word, having that type of relationship with him to get the desires of your heart. And what you may think is a desire of your heart may not be a desire of your heart according to our Heavenly Father. And so that's why a lot of things we desire, we don't get. Especially as children of God. You know, and then even when you grow in God, you don't even focus on desires like that no more. You just let whatever be. You just do what you called to do. You be obedient, and whatever blessings God brings into your life, thank you, Heavenly Father, and you keep it moving. You know, you really don't focus on that type of stuff no more, because you already know. When you got a relationship with him, he got you on all levels. And whatever is for you, gonna be for you. And what's not for you, it ain't gonna happen. And you understand that. You don't get mad. You don't get an attitude. You don't question it. Because you know your Heavenly Father is doing what's best for you. You know what I'm saying? Because we don't really know what's best for ourselves. We don't. Because if we could have did all the things that we wanted to do, oh my gosh. You know, and it's not all about money either. You know, because money is money. It done got to the point, y'all, look, I'm tired of shopping. I'm tired of spending money. I'm just over it. I do what I have to do, but all this, like I be taking the girls to the mall and all that, like, ugh. I'm just tired of spending money, you know, like, and me and my wants, it's not even that major anymore. I'm really kind of sort of content. Only thing that I really have on my mind that I want is my refrigerator. That's basically the biggest thing that, yeah. You know, like furniture and stuff, that'd be when my stuff is just kind of done. It ain't no good, then I go there. But I always have been a really content person. You know, growing up the way I grew up in the projects with a single parent, my mom being a single, you know, single parent mom over me and my two brothers. I'm the oldest and everything. I didn't have it like that. We didn't have it like that. So it was okay though. When I look back, I think that's why I'm the person I am today, because of my humble beginnings. It ain't nothing to go without something. You know what I'm saying? Because we was in that type of situation where my mom borrowed sugar, borrow this and borrow that. Sharon go ask so and so. Sharon go ask so and so. And that's okay. You know what I'm saying? Because I remember those things, and I just thank God from where I come from, y'all, and everything. And we made it. My mama did it. You know, she raised me and my brothers and everything. We had clothes on our backs. It might want the type of clothes like some of my friends had back in the day. Nikes had just came out. I never had owned a pair of Nikes until I met my hubby. Okay. And that was like 25, 26. It wasn't no big deal though. I didn't get mad at my mama because she ain't buy me no Nikes, or I didn't have the latest gym shoes. And back then it was these jeans like Von Jewish, Gloria Vanderbilt's, Chardons, and it was just Levi's that was coming on the scene. And they used to have the pants with the Playboy going down the leg. I had friends that had that. Me, not. But I didn't envy my friends for it, and I didn't get mad at my mama for it. I ain't like, I want this, I want that. That just wasn't me, and it still ain't me. I don't got the how. You know, what I get, I get. What I don't, I'm good. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it makes you like, it came from the recognize that desires are not needs. And I guess growing up, God did supply my mom with the resources to keep us what I need things that we needed. We had a roof over our head. I had clothes. I mean, the clothes was clothes. You know what I'm saying? We had food to eat. It probably wasn't like all that, you know, eat the same meal every Sunday. But then I think about the children of Israel, how God had, they had to eat manna like for 40 years. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, hey, it is what it is, you know? So yeah, I'm really thankful and I'm grateful. I don't need all that, you know? I don't want all that. I don't desire all that. It's just, that's just one of my beginnings. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, cause that stuff will get in the way of you being a servant for your Heavenly Father, for you being obedient to your Heavenly Father. You got to be able to know how to put self aside to serve for your Heavenly Father and be obedient, you know, because a lot of things He requires for us to do as His children requires for you to put yourself aside, put your emotions aside. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I thought that was a really, really good read. So that's how you know when healing starts to happen, because you're not so self-centered. You start to become more about God. You start to become more God-centered and other people-centered. And that's true. Because I got a lot of little stories, like even growing up in, you know, being in the projects, living in the projects most of my life. Up until I moved in the projects, I think I was 6 or 7. I didn't move out the projects, so I was like 27. So I stayed in the projects like a really long time and everything. And I wouldn't change nothing about it because it's just, man, my foundation built up on it. But by being a lot of us in the projects, we became more like a unit, more like a family. We looked out for each other like that. We had each other backs like that and everything. So God used me like how my mama used to ask people, like Sharon go ask so-and-so, do they got some sugar or this or that or the other. I was the one people would come to and ask me for that. And I was there for them for that, you know, because I remembered what it was like. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. Yeah, and it's about people. It's about being there for people. You know, like it's just so many times I did end up that and everything, and I wouldn't change it. I like doing for people. That makes me feel good when I do for people, regardless of their reactions or their whatever. It always made me feel like it gave my life meaning, like purpose. You know what I'm saying? So, and then having a lot of kids, hey, look, buying clothes like that for myself, yeah. Always my kids, my family first. I didn't buy all that. I still got some of the same clothes. Probably oldest arena I be still wearing. You know, I don't really like, you know, like you don't have time to be focused on stuff like that when you gotta take care of nine kids. No. So I think everything, the way I grew up, having my family and everything was all steering me to this, to where I'm at today. You know, like just a giver. I'm not a taker. But if somebody blessed me with something, it's cool, but I like to be the one to give. You get what I'm saying? I like to be the one that make people feel good on the inside, put a smile on their face and everything, you know. And that's why I do this. You know, it might not be like a physical gift, but knowledge is a gift. Wisdom is a gift. Just whatever I bring to the table and it make you feel good or encouraged or inspired or motivated, or I'll be like, that's what it's all about, giving. So y'all, I guess that's about it. I'm talking. I gotta go down here and see what letters I got. And it's some more other things I gotta do. I got a little list and everything. So I hope y'all enjoyed that read and my input as usual. Oh, so yeah, on that note, I hope everybody have a blessed Wednesday, a safe Wednesday, a productive Wednesday, get her done, and a protective Wednesday slash Thursday. And I see y'all back at the table on Friday. And on that note, peace, love, share something. What? Oh, y'all, the hubby got this little thing. It was this song, Old Town Road and stuff. He put me up on it. I'm like, I kind of really like that. I never really thought about. I watched the video and I'm like, I like the video too. Old Town Road, but. What's his name? Lil Nas, Lil something, and Billy Ray Cyrus. Well, a black boy, young man, acting like a cowboy. Wow. Which I done heard it was like real black cowboys back in the day, but that ain't what I grew up seeing. So, okay, y'all. On that note, I'm out. Bye, y'all.
Going for my folk trying to get by. Came through the struggle with my head high. Being broke, you know what it feel like. I said, being broke made me rich. 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 Gotta keep the stove hot so it cook right. If everybody eating, that's a good night. Gotta take a loss while I took flight. Hard times made for a good life. I said, being broke made me rich. 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 Yeah, never fell in love with the cocoa. Had to hold up the stove with the fofo. Never had the dough kicked in by the feds while I'm laying in the bed on a prayer that I'm gon' blow. But I do know what it feel like to go to school with the knockoff shoes. Eating free lunch, trying to act all cool. Well, you better know that.